Hello, I'm Sasha, and this is a follow-up to my recent video, Medical Director's Negligence, when I detailed how Dr. Malcolm Samuel, Optimax's very own medical director, programmed the Nidec laser machine with the wrong setting, resulting in the astigmatism in a patient's eye being doubled. So many people have contacted me to express their horror not only at the fact this happened, but that Dr. Samuel is still employed at Optimax as medical director and continues to operate on people's eyes. Perhaps he knows too many secrets. I've also been questioned as to whether everything I say could possibly be true. Indeed it is. Otherwise, I can assure you, Optimax's lawyers would have had me tied up in court by now. I have recordings of my meetings with Russell Ambrose on the 3rd and 25th of July, spanning approximately 4.5 hours, when we discussed not only Mark's case, but that of Mr. Abbs, who had his eye lasered in the wrong place by another allegedly negligent Optimax surgeon. This was a simple case of oops, missed. Meanwhile, to put at rest any doubts regarding the validity of my claims, please listen to the following, where on the 3rd of July 2012, Russell Ambrose clearly states, "This is a clear case of negligence. We've made a mistake. We've put our hands up. I didn't know it was negligence until Shiraz pointed it out, and Malcolm's going to have to deal with it."
No, I know, but I'm...
This is a clear case of negligence. We've made a mistake.
Yeah.
Now, as I say, I didn't know it was negligence until Sasha Sherez
difficult
pointed it out.
Yeah.
And...
Right.
During that meeting, Russell also told me if I hadn't pushed for Mark's external consultation with Mr. Shiraz Dea, he'd have had retreatment and it would have all been over, and no one would even have known a mistake was made. That would be okay then. He also said, "Malcolm is very worried about his reputation. He's made a human error." Malcolm's worried? I think the patient whose eyes he damaged might be a tad worried too. Russell went on to say he wanted to know how a fail-safe computer system allowed this mistake to happen. Russell, please, because it's obviously not fail-safe. At a following meeting on the 25th of July, Russell informed me Malcolm has admitted responsibility. Since then, I've been invited to a meeting at the House of Commons in September to discuss a major independent report into the refractive eye surgery industry, which is currently being ignored by Sir Bruce Keogh, who, as my recent correspondence with him showed, simply isn't interested. He suggested I complain to the CQC or fill in an online complaint. By the way, whilst the emails came from Sir Bruce's email address, they were in fact written by his business manager. As I replied to Sir Bruce, I can only presume there's not enough sexy publicity to pressure him into any action. Surely, an industry allowing people's corneas to be burned away in the wrong place and other major mistakes made by incompetent and negligent surgeons at high street clinics like Optimax is equally important as one responsible for dodgy breast implants, if not more so. See Myra Pridden's story. She was left blind for a year following Professor Jan Venter's negligence when he was senior clinician at Optimax. How many more have to suffer before this industry is regulated? Please sign the petition below calling for government legislation. It is so important.